Well, hello there. This is James coming at you. You're gonna see me do a little painting using Aaron Blaze's hair and fur brushes for doing, well, a fan art for Star Trek of a Tribble. You know, that episode from the old Star Trek TV show, Trouble with Tribbles. So I'm going to make a Tribble. I already got the background logo that I got going here for it. And it looks pretty good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint the Tribble. And this is what I'm starting out with. I'm just using a circle as a reference for how I'm going to be making the Tribble. So what we have to do here is I have to bring my monitor screen down some. There we go. Click on my remote. And we're going to do this. Bring it over so I can see it a lot better. So, anyways, we're going to go to brush set. And we're going to get the Aaron Blaze hair brush set number 2 already open. Going to think, which one am I going to use to make it fluffy? Which one do you guys think I should use to make it really fluffy? We can use this one right here. Too spaced out. Default settings in these brushes are quite the same. So we're gonna bring it in more. Cut down on spacing, shape dynamics, size jitter. Bring that down just a bit. Scatter. Yeah, we want more like a bunched. Yeah. Here we go. It's a little pretty big. I think I'm gonna cut down on that. There we go. That's more control. Well, here we go. It doesn't really matter which direction I'm painting because I can always reverse it. Yeah, but this is the base for the hair. Okay, so we got this as a base. Going for it. Now we're gonna go for, oh wait a minute, you can't really see this, can you? I gotta adjust this so you can see it. There you go. Now we're gonna go to new layer. Bring this up a little bit. New layer, and then we're gonna try. Which one should we do? What is this one like? Oh, that's just for texturing. Ain't really nothing much to that. Oops. Forward. Undid my layer. Okay. We also got another hair and brush set here from him. Gotta make it more. Oh, we can make it woolly. Well, right here. Tell you what wool looks like. Shape dynamics. Up. Well, here. That's what woolly looks like. Yeah, that looks a little more fluffier. Now I'm gonna degrease the brush down a little bit. Get a little more shorter hairs into it. There you go. We got longer hairs, we got short hairs. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Now I want it to be a little bit bigger. So what we're gonna do, put another layer above this. There you go. This all looks pretty fluffy. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna duplicate these. As a group, put them in a folder, and these here we're just going to uncheck. I'm going to save this as Fluffy Tribble. And then what we're doing, duplicate the group. Ah, shit. Me and my stupid Parkinson's. There we go. Now with this group, we are going to merge the group as a single entity on here. And then we're gonna try this. This is Fluffy Monster Generator. We're gonna go to Color Fluffy. And even though this brush is like part of Monster, the Fluffy Monster Generator, they got their own brushes and stuff, and it's nothing like this. But yeah, this coloring thing that automatically put color palettes onto it and stuff, it's very useful and helpful for this type of situation. So boom, there you go, that quick. And what we're going to do, we're going to come here, the beveling, bring that down just a tad. And what we want to do, we want to put up the shading a little bit. Alright, because we want some shading going on here. Shadows. We got glow here. I don't know why glow is black, but it is. And then we got regular shadow here. That kind of brightens it up. But yeah, they got white for this, so I want it black. I want to give it a little bit more shadow. Give it a little bit more roundness appeal to it for right now. I can always change it back. Not sure what that did. There we go. There we go. Now what we're going to do here. How do I want it? Orange one or what? Nah. We want a brown one, a dark brown one, light brown, actually no, light brown here, and then here, we want to give it a dark brown for stripes and stuff. Then we're going to go here, see how the color changes a bit? Yeah, that worked out pretty good. So that's basically the tribble. And here we can adjust things for like more shadows and stuff. Like we're gonna put more effects to it. Like gradient. Gradient. See how that works. Gives it more light there. Color overlay, boom, that brightens it up more. This dims it. Bring it down just slight. And we want a little bit of a drop back shadow here, don't we? Drop shadow. Distance. Not sure that really works, but if it don't really come out that well, can always do it the traditional way for making a shadow. Yeah, I think I'll do traditional shadow. So we'll take that out. But anyways, here, As you can see, we have pretty much a solid ball of fur. Now we're gonna go over here, we're gonna go over to the layer mask for this color tablet or color tab. And we're just gonna go over here. Let's see. How are we gonna paint this out? Could use the same, but yet we have to put it into white for this one. Completely white. And then we can come down on the brush. See what I'm doing here? Curving with it. Step on the tube. Not bad, huh? You got a little kink right here. It's a bit too thick for that one. All right, hang on. Right back. Okay, I'm back. As you can see here, you can take the same furry brush and paint over it to give its markings and stuff. might as well make it one death as long as you bring the bus down a little bit. So yeah, now we get a tighter stripe. And a tribble. Why not make it unique? We can save that. So it turned out pretty good. Now I can adjust the under color here if I wanted to be more darker, or just be black and white. Bring this up to be orange over here. Hey, what about the blue one? An alien tribble. Yeah, let's see. Ooh, a purple one. A pink one. Can't remember. Let's do tribbles. Tribbles, triple, tribbles. Images, see what different colors they got. They got brown, they got white, they got gray. They got any other colors on that one? Look at this picture here. So you got gray and white, and then you got brown, light brown, orange brown. I'm not sure there's any other colors here. Well, they got color palettes here. Not sure why that's happening. All right, here we go. Someone just did that, see? The original tribbles, they were just basically brown and stuff. Brown and gray. A tan tribble, like look at that one. That one got different color markings. Like that one. White and black. This one here on the cartoon, big fat tribble. He's pink. Tribbles, triple, triples. So let's see. Oh, look at that one. Let's take that. Let's save that picture. And look at this artwork here. This is funny. Poor Spock and Kirk there, all messed up in troubles. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Yeah, so we can basically change the color on this now. We can change it like to be a purple tribble, green tribble. See if we can adjust the gray and white. White tribble. Put it on white. And then you come down here. And it's like this. Make it white. And then this color. Instead of being brown, you can make it black. Black and white, tiger. Yeah, there you go. That's a good one. So what we'll do here, we're going to save that. Yeah, we already saved that, so we're going to take out the background. And we already got this. And we're going to save it as PNG. And then from this here, see, this is the insignia design here. Do you remember what image size that is? Well, just 300. Now we can take this, oops, wrong tool. We can take this, bring this in front of this. Like that, and you can put that in the folder, boom, group. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna merge the group. There, now it's just a regular picture. Or we can do this, step back, keep the group, triple, transform, and bring it down just a bit. Just set it right about there. And then for the rest of this, I'm just going to go down. Boom. Like that, summarized. Duplicate that group. Merge the other one. I want to make sure I got perfect summarized. So we're going to do this little trick here with Photoshop. Yeah. Save this. Go back. Star Trek Queen Signia. Come on. And if we want a little shadow underneath the tribble here, which actually there ain't no ground here, he's just floating in space. You know. We can actually duplicate the group. Merge that group bring underneath, and then we'll still be in the same spot as that, and then we're just gonna colorize it to black, set it to normal. Logging opacity all the way up, make sure everything else is good, and then from there we're going to rasterize it. And it's just going to be like a little shadow. Then we're going to take the free transformation and bring it down just a bit. Like so. Boom. And I'll keep its shape, but down. Take augment opacity, bring it down. And there we go. We made a shadow. So we made a shadow of that one. So we're gonna save it. So what we're gonna do, I also wanna go back Well, this ain't the one way. Close that one. Where are we? We in 9. Ah, here's the original image of the Tribble. Windows 10 sucks. It really does. It sucks. So you can click on that to pop up for image, and it just like poop poop. It poops itself. See, that's the original image of a Tribble from Star Trek. From the original series. And here's this image. And see, waiting for it to pop again. I thought Windows 10 was supposed to be faster, Bill Gates, huh? Bill Gates? Bill Gates, are you watching YouTube? Probably not. Bill Gates is such a smug. That's my opinion of Bill Gates. He stole the operating system from Apple years ago, and then he just reverse engineered it, well, more or less reverse mirrored it, and he didn't have the whole algorithm for the operating system either, and he just reverse mirrored it and called it Windows. And then he built upon it from there. And that's why all the time it kept on crashing throughout all his presentation, and that's the reason why it crashed with a lot of users and stuff until now. Right now it don't really crash that much anymore. But before, the algorithm for the operating system, he didn't have the full thing. There was only bits and pieces in what he had. That was it. But he couldn't terrorize it onto another drive fully. When you do that, when you go and, you know, try to undo the source code of an operating system or any application itself, you're not going to get the full algorithm out of it. So you see how this is right here, this image right here? I'm going to see if I can make one like that. It's probably not going to come out the same, but what I'm going to do, and see, there's more than one image. Bring in stupid Windows 10. I'm going to bring this up. And on here, I'm going to see what the image size is for it. Oh, that's not very big. Uncheck it so we can enlarge it more. Like, say, 300 resolutions. Yeah, that should be good. Then we're just gonna add another layer. I'm gonna take the old pen tool. See if we can duplicate this. I'm actually gonna use color this time. And what we want the dark color to start out with. And actually, boom. We want the dark color. A dark brown color. And we're not going to use Wally. We're not going to use that brush set. We're going to go here. We're actually going to try this. See if that will work out better for this. Get size for that. Facing. Dynamics. Scatter. We'll bring scatter up a bit. So, let's see. We want basically the same color pretty much. What we're going to do, we're going to bring down the bottom, opacity down a bit. Oops. It's not going to come out the very same as this. Maybe I should have used the straight hairs. Yeah, I think that's what I'll do. I'm going to use the straight hairs. Oops. Damn thing. What was that all about? Photoshop got bugs. And Adobe stupid, don't fix them all. So yeah, I wanted this here to enlarge and erase it, because Photoshop don't have a thing for the layer you're on to delete whatever you got on there. Right off the bat, the whole thing gets cleared out. No, they don't got that. They weren't smart enough to put that in. So let's see. Which one should I use? I always like 73. 75.3. Okay, so I'm going to enlarge this brush more. Yeah, that's too enlarged. Yeah, Photoshop has bugs, especially working with Wacom. They don't design it to work with Wacom, even though they claim they do. They're full of crap. But yeah, they're full of crap. The reason why the simple applications like Manga Studio, Clip Studio Paint, which they call it now, is more simple application with sketching and stuff that you can still paint in that too, and it's very application. You get very little bugs in that system for that application for a program. Compared to Photoshop, Photoshop got so much shit in it that it just boom, it explodes. So, scatter. Dynamics, jit count, down. Bring that down too. And so here we go. I'm trying to make it the best we can. See, the scatter is way too off on this for here, for whatever. Hair's not that scattery, it's more or less clumped. So, Aaron Blaze, you need to fix that, because it's really not that scattery. Things should not, see, it should be like this. Very much down, because hair's more, you know, together instead of scattered out. It's not like a bunch of leaves on a tree. So yeah, I'm gonna try to get this the best I can to look like this, if I can do it. This thing is so wild like that, it's kinda hard. Hard to do that. Now we got stomping and running upstairs once again. The buttholes of America. They were awake. Oh my god, I'm feeling lies! Get off the sidewalk! Step back. What we're gonna do ain't feasible. I'm kidding. I'm gonna take both of these and let shrink them down a bit. So we get more space going here. And if that, I'm gonna make a background layer. And we're gonna go back. There we go. And with that, we're gonna call it background to lock it. So yeah, so we're gonna go back to this. Undo that, come up. Bring that all the way in. Boom, 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 boom. Try to get it to be the matching for right now. I'm just coloring this in. It went darker. Oh well, I'll just color over it. And we'll blend in together. See, we've got enough room to do shit, but I want to see what I'm doing. You can see the texture I have in here going up here. I'm blending in with this. And I'm putting pressure to get it to be a little bit more frizzy. Back steps. Oh, that went up kind of big, didn't it? Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to use the scattering a little bit. Oops. Oh, maybe I just went down. Just change the shape. Yeah, it's a little bit. A little thicker here. There you go. So now, what we're going to do here, we're going to lock, well, not completely lock the label, we're going to lock it to a point so it can't do anything outside the image itself. And we're going to go here, and we're going to lighten it up. Down on the brush sides, and we're gonna, soft light. I guess not. Multiply. Makes it too dark. Color dodge. Ah, here we go. See what's happening there? Just get too lighter. So yeah, we're just skimming. We just need to skim a little bit. We don't need to bring it in that light. There we go. We got different colors into it. Now, what we want to do, I'm going to bring in a little bit more white and stuff into it. So we want to put this scatter count up a little bit more higher. Jitter down. Oh, let's see the size. Spacing up a little bit more. Oops. And let's say multiply. Yeah, multiplying, doing it. Let's add normal. Yeah. It's not really working for me. Oops. So what we can do. With this, we can now layer. Brush space. Yeah, we're going through this. Yeah, and reset that. General flow scatter. with this, what we want to do here, go to color burn, here, I'm going to try different settings, darker, screen, lighten, you know, color dodge. Oh, that looks different. Huh. Add color tones, and that just makes it white. Lighter. Overlay. Soft light. Just whitening. Hot light. Vivid light. Lighten things up a little bit. Any light. Pin light. Hard max. Difference. Exclusion. Subtract. Divide. Hue. Keep it in as hue. Let me do another layer. And this one, we are going to have a lighter brown, black. Yeah, that's a little bit too big. For this type of thing, check out. Okay, I want to check spacing down a little bit more. This is just going to be a texture thing right here. I'm going to go over and lock the layer for transparency. And then from here, I'll bring it down a little bit darker. See? And then we go back of this. A little bit more texturing here. Back to this one. Oops. Blend in. And also with this one, I'm doing a little drop shadow. No distance. Just a little bit. Yeah. And I was going to put a second. There you go, so it gives a little bit more characteristic to it. this name for that too. And on this one, I'm going to have it a little bit lighter. Gray on there. Yeah, see? Gave it a little bit more characteristic to it. And we're going to make another layer. And do the same thing here. Here, do the drop back shadow part of bone with black. Go back to this one. And a shadow to it. Maybe not. And a glow. And a glow. What do you want for any glow? More like this. Now that's a bit different tribble. We're gonna save that. Wiggy tribble. Take that out. Boom. There you go. Yep, it needs sustained. Undo that, undo that, undo that. And, you know, we need a lot better brush on here, don't we? Okay, now there's no holes in it. Yeah, I got some more shake to it. There's holes there. Boom, 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 boom.
Get everything back.
Here we go. It didn't turn out exactly like the picture, but I just got the shape down. That was it. And I wanted this little texturing here with it. It had a little curve of a football going in. And actually, we're going to go here again, and we're going to sort of bring this in a bit more. I'm actually going to uncheck that. There we go. It comes in here. Get that checked. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna go over here, the drop shadow. See if we can play around the distance here a little bit. No, probably not. That's alright, there's another way to fix that, so it's not looking like it's completely out of whack from it. We're gonna duplicate this. Also go to the original source and unbind blend clip layer as group. And we're gonna go to this one. Same thing. But that one, so you're gonna check the main one, and then this one here gonna rasterize it. Then we're going to go over to layers, layer mask, and then from here we're actually going to use a regular brush to do this. We want a soft. Then from here, we're gonna go back to here and get black. So, I gotta see a lot better. Now it gives it the characteristic that what I was looking for. So there we are. That's one way to do it. And for the main body part, we want to undo that and check to see how low that is up to. Go back to my brush. Scatter down to size, spacing. Make this more solid as possible. This is the
underline here. Now we check to see how that goes. Yes. I'm doing this one. Let's tidy up just a little bit. So find a little bit. So yeah, now we got some black hairlines going through it. I'm going to do this one, that one, that one. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to add to this a little bit. There we go. So now we should take that out. We didn't really brush that. There's the other one that was giving it away. I'm just going to move it. Just to give it some characteristics. Okay, so I think I'm done with that. It seemed to come out pretty good. There's a few extra wily hairs there, but that's not biggie. We got touch on. Okay, I gotta make sure it's off. So that turned out alright. For Brownman. So yeah, I was trying to duplicate that image, but I couldn't. For the life of me, even with the hairbrushes, it just couldn't. Tragic, but I wanted that characteristic, this little curl right here, a little wave of hair curl right there. So that's what I wanted for characteristic, to, you know, look like a little fuzzball. So then we can use this in the fan art. PNJ. Have this file. So yeah, this turned out pretty good. So we got this scene with Tribble, the black and white one. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna bring in the other one. Okay. And put them in the folder. Wiggy Tribble. And we're gonna bring more. Ah, see, he didn't even take that much room. So the other one here, we're gonna undo that one. Bring him here, and then take this one here and resize him a bit. Okay. And well, we got a little shadow going already. We'll do this kind of has a new wiggy. Yeah, wiggy, it's really. Listen, budge him just a little bit. To match up that shadow. And there you go. Now we got a new one. We're going to save this. And call it Wiggy. Oops. So there we go. And we want the ship. See, that's a 3D model. Yeah, I got a 3D model of J.J. Abrams and Abrams. So now we're getting too far out because I gotta go and readjust what the thing to be for a ship and also what plates. Maybe. So what we're gonna do here.
I'm gonna sign it.
Brush I use them all the time. I'm going to bring it down. Why is it doing that? Is that normal? Uncheck. There we go. Gets my signature to it. But I'm gonna decrease my signature. After that, we got this PNG. And my fan art is done for that one. And then all I'm going to do is I'm going to go and just take out the name Wiggy. And I'm just going to use the other picture of the other tribble I made and put that in and have a new picture. Hopefully the place I'm going through for the fan art for this will set above them. So yeah, like I said, whenever you're painting, like say if you're trying to duplicate an image or whatever, all right, and that doll, that triple doll I saw, and I saw how it was fuzzing and everything. Look, I'll show you again. Where is it? Where is my triple head gone from? Where is the triple? There it is. There it is. See how wiggly it is and stuff like that? Imagine I probably couldn't demonstrate that. I see how fluffy it is. See, mine didn't even come out to be even like that. But I wanted that little curl expectation of the hair going in there. But it didn't happen! I look at photos and you can't really see that good because it's black background. Crap. Can we change the background? Can we? Can we change the background to something else? Okay, let's see how that does. All right, close it. All right, still black. Still black. Hello. So, let's take that photo again. I'm trying to do this one more time. Just one more. Yeah, we gotta enlarge it. Let's say. Actually, how about 400? Up here to white. Here. Edit for transformation. Lock. Okay. Should be good for now. Background layer. Let's see if we can do this. Really, really do this. It really irks me that I can't do it. So I'm gonna go with that. And then we're gonna start spacing down. Sounds down, scatter down. We want a color. It's too small. Okay, that, back down with me, another one. Yeah. I guess it's done.
We'll see. See how messy it came out to be.
So what we're gonna do, we're gonna do a bunch of stuff here. I'm gonna add a drop shadow to just what every single one of these.
So it was an easier way to have the drop shadows.
And you just click them on and boom, it's all there. Checking.
Yeah, now, so you give it a little texturing, like the hair flowing, messy, different ways. So what we're gonna do, these are just the faces of one of these. Them showing right now, and then we're going to go into this folder and we're going to rasterize all of these. Okay, now they're all rostered. So the back one, which is way out back here, we don't really need to do anything for that for anything. It's just some of these other ones. We do like the very front one right here, like that one. We
have to do something about that. Let's undo that. Because if I go and do a blade mass on the front one here, that one, and this is going to be showing, so we get to, okay, that one, and that one. We got to do this one. So, I'm going to have to delete that curve I just made. So now let me go all the way down and click. Duplicate. Put that in the folder. And we're going to go uncheck these once more. Okay, and it's that one right there. So basically, I don't really have to rasterize all these. It's just this top one right here, this beginning one. And we're going to go over to add layer mask. So we're going to do this. With the layer mask, get that brush completely black. And now the brush just so. Not really working out the way I want it. I'm gonna have to go and use one little brush. So. Okay, let's see what's going on. It's the yellow one. It's this one. We're gonna have to rasterize that one too. There we go. See how it comes in now? Taking out a And let's see. That's fine. Okay, that one. That one you just want. Let's rasterize it. And that's that one too. And then just take out some of this. So, pointy. So there we go. We can do that one too. And we can do this now. Rest. And rest. Yeah, you should rest, right? Every single one of them. Rest your eyes! Then go to this one. Some type of blending here going on. Here, boo. Not good. Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Where are we? Here we go. Give a little background. Solidness. So what we'll do, we'll just uncheck these real quick so I can make this. Just give a little background thing going here for a solid type of layer. Will this be like call like the foundation? Like when you're building a house, you need your foundations first. Or just like how women put on makeup.
I need my foundation. Where's my foundation?
This is just a vacuum, so I'm not going to be really fancy with this. I don't have too much going here. This is just going to be a background to it, so it gives it more solidness to what I just did. There we go. So now we're right here. Boom. We got that one going. I'll fix that a little bit. Back. Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're just taking it away. Now, I'm going to do this, and it'll blend. Oops, I cut one. Yeah, why is it off? Getting close. There's cons in there. What's this? Okay, that looks a bit better. And this one. Masterize.
And let's see, which one's fine. That one seems to be all right. That's fine. Run away. Oh, here we are. There's that one. There's that one. This. Right about there. Okay, now let's save this. That's basically what it is, it's a dragon. So now we get that. Now we should put a new layer here. We're just going to do a little. Go down to our brushes. Use that one again. Let's do this a bit. And see, we got black, so we can put black on this top. So that's on a different layer, so everything's all protected here. Brown, make it lighter. And this one. Brown, make it darker. I think I might need more scattering. A little bit more spacing on this. Yeah, that's normal. That's lighting it up. Now what we can do now, we can go here and change the multiply. I'm gonna erase this part right here. Spacing, scattering. Okay, that's only want a little bit of texture, just flowing here, flowing there. I don't want much. That's what I'm trying to give it a little bit of texturizing. I'm gonna make this little tiny hairs, it's like different colors and stuff. What color band looks dark in them? Light. Screaming. And the light is a little more. Color dodge.
Add color dodge.
Overlay. Soft light. Hard light. Vivid. What about linear? Pin light? Oh, that's a normal.
Pin light.
Oh, I won't. Hard max. I'm gonna race. Race it all. Is it all raced? Okay. So what was the multiply? Yeah, multiply does this. So why don't you want to go on the ground, blue sky, or genocide up there?
So yeah, there you go. Gives it some color depth into it.
Let's see, you get multiply color burn.
Let's see how it looks.
Color burn.
Menu. Color dodge. So we're gonna go back to multiply, and that looks fine the way it is. Dead. You saw me do two tribbles. Actually, three. And this one, I was trying to mimic that picture, but I couldn't. Oh my god, he's bald! Where is he balding? Let's be up here someplace. Where is he balding? Right there, that one. I mean, it's this. He needs to be painted. So I'm gonna have to pick down the. I can put the shape sign scatter down. Shape dynamic spacing down. See, I want it to look like, you know, flowing real hair instead of, you know, too clunky or whatever. You know, so it has its own spaces in between the hairs and stuff, but when it comes to certain areas that's more close to the center, I don't want it to be bald either. Or even to the sides. Hair is supposed to be falling out the way it should be. It's kind of a little fluffy and stuff. Well, there we go. I guess it's that one. day.
So yeah, so we did the black and white round ball one. Then we got the other twiggy, wiggy one. The first try. And ragged is the new one. So what I'll do, I'll just submit all three of them to the website I'm going through for the fan art, and they can decide which one they want. Because, if I was doing a regular thing like this, I would be doing photo manipulation and stuff like that, but I don't like some painting and drawing myself. Like, here's the one for Wiggy. And Windows 10 sucks. There's a lot of people that want Windows Media back, and we can get Windows Media back, but the thing is, it's hidden in the files and you have to unlock it. So I got Windows Media. It takes a while for it to pop up. Anything on Windows 10 takes a long time to pop up. Because Microsoft lies, oh, it's faster than Windows 8.1. Bullshit. They lie. Yeah, so this one looks pretty good. I like this. This one looks good. And then, did I save the one? Oh yeah, I forgot to save the one for, whatchamacallit, for this. Yeah, I've got Twiggy, and then there's this one. Yeah, so, I'm gonna save that as, Tiger. Come on. So I was doing the same PDF file and stuff. I just unchecked it. I'm like, hey, what's wrong with me? Yeah, that looks pretty good with that one. And then there's the other one. So they can choose which one they want. Really. Here's this little guy. Back up there, so I'm saving and put the folder on top of this one and save that one too. Yeah. It's a fun day. And I get a little steady. Transform. Why can't I transform? Is there something blocking me? Oh. Yeah. Okay. Unlock. This one Shaggy Trouble. That looks cute.
Tribbles.
So, I guess that's pretty much safe now, isn't it? Yeah, there's all three of them. So, I'm going to cut this short. Actually, I've been going on for almost 2 hours. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Shaggy looks all right, but Wiggy. Oh, anyways, that's that. Looks even more fluffier. So I like Wiggy the best. And then we got this one. Size him down a bit. I can like baby triple. And with that we can even keep the poop. And merge the group. And underneath him. I'm gonna do the same thing we did before. So color. It. Boom. And I'm going to do this. Just like I did before. See, it keeps its shape. I'm going to bring it down. And we're going to find out. Got 78. And this one. We have 782. Let's see, the other one doesn't have any time for the other thing. I think the other one looks whiter. Very whiter. So I want to make it whiter. We'll add this. Here's the new one.
Tribbles.
So there's two of them. So, all that saving and stuff, if you like the video, please give a thumbs up, please subscribe to my channel to help me grow and be part of the community more, and also so I can put out more content and more videos for you. From here out, have a nice day. I might be back on later, I'm not sure, we'll see. I might be doing some news for Star Wars or something, who knows? But I got some other work to do, and I got some studying to do. Also, I got some art studying to do as well. And practicing, you know, more of my sketching and stuff, my sketching skills and stuff. So, have a good day.